Now we have the first of three semi-finals for the men's 200 metres. Mikael Ashmead, training partner of Tyson Gay in Florida. He goes in three, the only other man to go under 20 seconds other than you know who. And we'll see him in the second semi-final. So, Ashmead goes in lane three. Christophe Lemaitre, the Frenchman, goes in five. And Kim Collins, who got the bronze medal in the 100 metres, he starts on the outside. And Ewan Thomas, so many people are tipping Lemaitre to go under 20 seconds this season. He's pure talent.
He really is. His sprinting has improved so much technically over the last few seasons. I agree with you. I think he can go sub 20. He won't need to now, but come the final, if he wants to get near Bolt, he'll have to.
Lane one is empty. Ogunode, Nigerian representing Qatar in two. Ashmead, Jamaica three. Viana, Brazil in four. Lemaitre, France in five. Matiao of the Bahamas in six. Maslak of the Czech Republic in seven. And Kim Collins of St. Kitts and Nevis on the outside in lane number eight. Just 21 years of age, Mikael Ashmead, 19.95 this season. That was way back in April, but he did look good in his heat. And what can Christophe Lemaitre bring to this party? Only two to go through by rights.
Set. Stand up.
Well, there was a twitch there. The starters said stand up. And adding to the drama once more. It is tight qualification. I wonder whether it might be the Brazilian, Viana. He had really good form in his heat.
Would you disqualify the athlete in lane four?
Disqualified. Lane four.
I can hear over the speaker there, disqualify the athlete in lane four. He's not happy about that. The crowd are very noisy down there. You've got the long jump going on. He's not happy about that whatsoever. Unfortunately, as we've seen in the championships, one full start, you go.
That's a real shame for the Brazilian. He was really good in his heat to come through. We're just waiting for confirmation. And he's trying to talk to the officials.
On your mark.
Yes, well, we're just getting a replay there, and it's pretty obvious. So they're in their blocks once more. Ogunode of Qatar in two. Mikael Ashmead of Jamaica in three. Lemaitre, France in four. Matiao, Bahamas in six. Maslak of Czech Republic in seven. Collins on the left of your picture for St. Kitts and Nevis. Only six then, the first two to go through by rights. Kim Collins has started fast on the left, but can he hang on? Matiao of the Bahamas is going well, and now he's pulled up now. Lemaitre in the middle, Mikael Ashmead on the far side, and Kim Collins on the near side. Only the first two to go through. Lemaitre is taking it from Mikael Ashmead, and Ogunode goes through on the inside for third place. A really good run that by Lemaitre. Matiao of the Bahamas pulled up into a minus 1 meter headwind, 20.19, and that was a really, really strong closing 50 meters from the Frenchman. I think he took Ashmead by surprise a little bit.
It was quick, 20.17. That's just outside his fastest time ever, and it was into a minus wind. That is a headwind which you are going to feel coming off that bend.
Well, a decent start by Lemaitre and Ashmead both. Lemaitre not really making much moves at this point, but once he gets more comfortable at this point. This is where he gets more comfortable. He knows that he doesn't have too much more of that bend to have to tolerate with that funky form. Ashmead giving him all he can handle here, but here's what's great about Lemaitre. He knows that he can come through at the end, that he's got the speed endurance to be able to run the full 200 meters. 20.17, that's a good time for him in the semifinal. I think he will. We've talked about him going under 20 seconds. I think he will go under 20 seconds. That obviously won't be enough to contend with Usain Bolt at his best, but it could certainly be enough to get him a silver medal.
Ewan, how impressed were you with Christophe Lemaitre there?
Really impressed. Like Michael said, he's got that speed endurance. I tell you, he could run a good 400, this boy. He's got long stride length, and he bided his time. Did look slightly awkward coming off the bend, but into a headwind. That's a fantastic time. His best ever, 20.16. He's just done 20.17 into a headwind. What can he do in the final?